Welcome to my channel P-Concepts CHM. This video is about the experiment on thermistor characteristics, where we will study about the aim, apparatus, formula, theory, circuit diagram, procedure, observation table, graph, calculation, and result. Aim of the experiment: to study thermal characteristics of a thermistor. Apparatus: thermistor, DMM, that is digital multimeter, heater, water bath, oil bath. Formula: temperature coefficient of the thermistor is given as alpha is equal to 1 by r into dr by d theta. Unit of temperature coefficient is per degree Celsius. Dr by d theta is the rate of fall of resistance of the thermistor with temperature. Theory: if we talk about the metallic resistors, they have a positive temperature coefficient of resistance. That is, when you increase the temperature of the metal, it increases its resistance. For most metals, the resistance increases at a rate of about 0.4% per degree rise in temperature. In case of semiconductors, as you increase the temperature, there is a decrease in resistance. The decrease is at the rate of 6 to 8% per degree rise in temperature. All these resistors, they obey the Ohm's law, hence they are considered as linear. But there are certain resistors which we call as thermistors, which have very special characteristics. A thermistor is a device whose resistance is temperature sensitive, usually decreasing with an increasing temperature. That is, it has a negative temperature coefficient of resistance. It is a non-linear device which does not obey the Ohm's law. Thermistors can be subdivided into two groups. One, NTC thermistors having negative temperature coefficient of resistance. Second, PTC thermistors having positive temperature coefficient of resistance. So in NTC, with a rise in temperature, there is a fall in resistance. And in case of PTCs, as you increase the temperature, the resistance also increases. So we can summarize that thermistor is a heat sensitive resistor, usually made up of semiconducting material, such that its resistance varies appreciably with a change in temperature. So they have a high sensitivity to temperature changes, and they are extremely well suited for the precise temperature measurement, control, and compensation. They are widely used for such purposes, particularly in the lower temperature range of minus 100 degrees Celsius to plus 350 degrees Celsius. They are made by sintering mixtures of metallic oxides such as manganese, cobalt, copper, etc. As mentioned earlier, they are non-linear devices. This is the circuit diagram, which is very simple. There is a container or a beaker containing water. In that, a test tube is taken. In that, the thermistor is kept. The thermistor is connected to the digital multimeter, which will measure the resistance of the thermistor. Here, there is a thermometer to measure the temperature. You can heat this container with the help of a heater. So we are going to study the thermal characteristics. So we'll look into the procedure. So you keep the thermistor and the thermometer in the oil bath. You may immerse the test tube containing the thermistor in a water bath. Select a suitable range in the DMM and measure the resistance R of the thermistor at room temperature. Now you switch on the heater and note down the resistance of the thermistor with an interval of 5 degrees Celsius up to 65 degrees Celsius. Switch off the heater at 65 degrees Celsius and measure the resistance, that is take the readings till maximum temperature. Plot a graph of resistance R versus temperature theta. And then calculate the temperature coefficient alpha from the graph at 3 different temperatures. Now we will see the readings that were taken. So these are the readings of resistance. Resistance of the thermistor was noted down at different temperatures. First, the reading was noted down for room temperature at 29 degrees Celsius. We get a resistance as 1004 ohms. Then the heater is switched on and we increase the temperature by 5 degrees Celsius interval. So next reading is taken at 34 degrees, then 39 degrees, 44 degrees, so on till 65 degrees. You can till 65 degrees the readings are taken and then the heater is switched off, and then the maximum temperature that is attained is 69 degrees. At 69 degrees the final resistance is noted down. Then we plot a graph of R versus theta. You get a curve. Then we find the slope at different temperatures, like at 30 degrees Celsius. The slope is found using a mirror. Same thing is done at 45 degrees. The slope is found at 45 degrees and also at 60 degrees. The slopes are then substituted in the formula of temperature coefficient. This is the calculation where dr by d theta is the slope of the curve at that particular temperature, suppose at 30 degrees Celsius. The slope is minus 45 degrees and R1 is the resistance at 30 degrees that is substituted, and we get the temperature coefficient at 30 degrees as minus 0.049 per degree Celsius. Same thing is done for the other two temperatures also. We can see that the temperature coefficient value ranges between minus 0.03 to minus 0.04. So the value is in between that range. So in the result, we can note down the temperature coefficient. And we can say that a thermistor has a negative temperature coefficient. We can write down the temperature coefficient values that we have got at different temperatures. These are some of the e-resources that you can refer. Thank you for watching this video.